track IR would be really, really nice, Railworks. Please consider putting in track IR. He says, as if it's just a simple case of switching a button. I'm sure it's not, I'm sure it's much more involved. But it would still be nice. 160 it says on the thing, and 130 it's telling me here. I think it's just setting you up for craziness, isn't it? I'm just going to roll in nice and gentle. I've got 2 kilometers to Ulsan. Oh, it's Ulsan, not Eisen. Okay, Ulsan, that's an L as a third letter. Yes, 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 I'm here. What is my speed? 36, 37. Back it off. A little bit of brake. Just a eeny weeny teeny weeny eeny teeny weeny little bit. 160, yeah, right. Now this time we do need to start throwing on the brake a little bit, because the last time we nearly ran off the thing and we only have 700 meters. And I am doing well over 100 still, so let's start knocking this off fairly aggressively. We're arriving on good time. We're 42.19 actual. For a 43 scheduled. The estimation is putting us up close to 44, but that's not so believable. 40 is a decent number to start coming in on the rail with. And we'll try and get up to this rather uniquely designed. Now I think there's one of the programmers that is making this game is a lady, and I think she's responsible for this train station. Saw that on a YouTube interview kind of thingy. Right, we'll call that landed, and we'll pop out and have a look and open the doors, and yeah, it's a pretty cool kind of station, isn't it? Not your average boring grey soot covered from olden times and never been cleaned kind of station. Kind of got a garden on top and roof on the grass, and I say, it's bloody weird. We will be leaving on time. Excuse me? 167. Well, that'll do. We are proceeding. You kind of expect it to kind of go higher in notes, don't you? But it stops there. It's pretty realistic. Alrighty, so out we go from here and onwards. Onwards we go. And we are still within limits, so we are just going to push it through. Brake is off and everything is looking good. Our arrival is 11:04, and we have 50 kilometers to go. Might be able to nullify some of this minus, but I don't think we're going to be able to nullify it enough. We have to avoid incurring any more speeding tickets. So it says we can go up to 200, but we also have to be mindful that 160 is our next speed restriction. So, where do you think? Yeah, I think that's going to be good enough for a while. Yes, yes, thank you. I am aware. Let it coast. We have a 200 afterwards. It's really annoying that you have to slow down to speed up. there's a reason. Just annoying though. Yes, 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 yes. Look, we're two over the recommended. Chill out, for God's sakes. I know, I speed without any help, so you have a good reason to be worried. But I'm getting better, I'm kind of concentrating a bit more, so... Not going to tell you that the 200 is coming up, because there's really no reason to tell you until you're past it. I don't know if I see any 200 warning signs out there. Does ya? No. And it should be here. Now, you see that it's there. Our clock, our little pointer has moved up to the 200 to tell us you can now do 200, or try to at least, before I slow you down to 140. Don't know where that came from. Actually, there's a little bit of Craig Ferguson in there. That is a little Craig Ferguson-like, and if you don't know who Craig Ferguson is, YouTube Craig Ferguson, and CBS Craig Ferguson, and take it from there. You'll either love him or love him. He's your unorthodox late-night host. There's no Jay Leno here. His Bill Clinton, his Italian Bill Clinton, is quite fun. Anyway, enough of that. 160 is reported as the next restriction. Although you have no idea when that 160 is coming up. Until it'll start to... Yeah, okay, so it'll start to... The red light there, the G. Or whatever it is. Is it a G? Yeah. The G will start to light up and complain and give out. This is where track IO would be so cool, because you could just go in with your head and lean back and then you come back out. Hint. Not that anybody is going to see this, of course, but... Well, there's the 160 showing. And that's at 2 kilometers, so when will this G start to light up? At the 2 kilometer mark? Probably. Nope, 1.5? Yeah, 1.6, just under 1.6. And we could do a 200 afterwards. That's just killing me. I tell you, really? 160, and we're under, we're good. What a lame train horn. They could change that sound file, couldn't they? Or maybe that's what it actually sounds like. Seriously? You build a train as cool as this and that's the horn you put on it? Something wrong there. I'm just, you know, just making a comment. Now, the red flag is going to go up. You see, as soon as the engine passes the 200, you think you can go, but you can't. Now, there's a 160 as the next limitation anyway, so again, I'm not going to go much above 175. And it's warning me that we need to slow down again, so... I'm just trying to eke out a little bit of speed here and there as much as I can. Just to, you know, try and keep the schedule fairly decent. In a vain attempt to try and recoup my negative score still. I know it's not going to happen. I know. But you gotta keep trying. Because you never know. Although with this game. I got two more stops, so I might be able to... put it down to very, very small numbers. I might even be able to get into a positive number. It won't be very much. But I can't afford to make any mistake. No mistakes. No pressure. No, 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 no. Uh, 104, 1104, and we have 33 kilometers still to go. Ah, geez, we need to do faster speeds than this. Well, we don't actually. We'll probably do it fine at this speed, but it'd just be nicer to not have a speed restriction. Oh, excuse me. Air pressure is decent. .200 coming up. Dropping a little bit away from the 160, more than I want, so we'll apply a few more amps and we will try to address this. Got a bit of an incline going on too, it seems. I'm putting in 270 amps and not really getting anything back for it. 300 amps. 350 amps gives me something. I better save a couple of amps. 200 coming up. Good, good, good. Cue the hell out of it. So obviously you can do all of this from the console and you don't need this HUD, and I'm beginning to start to think. Notice I'm beginning to start to think, so this is really, really, you know, moving fast. But I'm of the opinion that it does make sense to get rid of this HUD fairly quickly before I become any more used to it than I am. But in order to do that, I need to be able to set up my hand controls. And the other day, 160, I got... The other day, I was looking in an electronics store, and they actually did have the train controller thingy. You know, the console controller, the hardware that you can buy. But it's 200 euros. Which is quite a bit, actually, 200 euros for what it is. It looks quite good. But then I read somewhere on a forum that there were some compatibility concerns with it, and that makes that 200 euros even a little bit more expensive. So I'm still toying with making my own. But I would need to have something to take away this. Well, I suppose I could do it with a mouse as well, in reality. There's no reason why I couldn't. Right, we're accelerating again, even though we are heading back to a 160 limit, a kilometer or two down the line. But until then, we should go like the wind. 2.5 kilometers to go, and we can keep going. We can keep going. Got a little bit of downhill coming as well, so she's going to start increasing speed all on her own. Green lights are good. Well, we have 2.7, we can slap it up a little bit. There's the 160 that we've been warned about. It's 2.5 kilometers away. We have a small decline, but nothing too serious. And I need to drop down 34 from here. So we let it run for a little while. Although we are coming up on it pretty quickly, really. And that momentum is sending us down the rail quite aggressively, so... Yeah, we're pretty good though. We're going to get down nicely. Oh god, we have a 200 behind it again. 20 kilometers still to go. 21, frankly. That's the 160 achieved. we're still okay on the time. Did I scare you? Come on, tell the truth. Okay, I didn't. Alright. So we do have another 200 coming up here, which is good, but you lose all of that momentum. Obviously, it is necessary. Otherwise, they wouldn't do it. 160, I'm just balancing on the 160. This is a stand back from the station edge, platform edge. There's the 200 that it's given me, and it's 200 up ahead, so 17 kilometers to go, and we can hopefully make some time up now. 1104, cell at glide 6. I said 6. Okay, well, yeah, we're doing okay. We can still make a little bit of speed up though. 192, 195, 196, 197. Back it down to 30% there and just hold it. 280 amps is not holding it, but increasing slightly. That's okay. 15 kilometers to go. Just under 200 an hour, so 15 to go, it would take 15 minutes, so we should really literally be there in about 7, which is what our estimated is from now. Well, 6 and a bit. Still have a 200 speed up ahead, so we have a good bit of distance of 200 to go. We've actually brought our estimated down by a few seconds as well, which is always good. Turn off that windscreen wiper for a while. There you go. Now we got a 150 coming up, although it's a little bit away, so I'm just going to take the drive out and just let her freewheel. We are going downhill, so we're not losing enough of the speed. This 150 could be a bit away though, we don't really know. Let's not lose too much too quickly. 2.7 kilometers at least, and more like 3 kilometers at least, so... Not sure where that 150 kicks in, but this worries me now that I don't see a 150 on the HUD. Alrighty then. Still doing quite a good old speed here. Throw in a few more amps just to keep it up, because we have quite a ways to go still, so... If we slow down too early, we're just costing ourselves unnecessarily a lot of time. Now I do need to knock off 50, and I'm traveling quite fast, so... you know, it's a quarter of my current speed, and that's a fairly decent amount. I'm going to need a bit of space to do that, but I think I'm probably going to have enough. Customers are all in the green. We have 6.4 kilometers to go. And time-wise, we are good. Ah no, we're speeding because we went up by one because I really didn't want that. You can't really do anything in this game if you're near the limit, and if you're not near the limit, You're going to be late. Yeah. That's what it is, folks. That's what she be. Now we are going to platform 6 here, which is 2.7 kilometers away, and we need to roll in on 50, so I'm just going to knock it off and we'll roll it in, start applying some brake. If we're getting down anywhere near the 120 mark by the time we get to the lights, which we won't at this speed, and I'll start to apply some brake. I want you to get down here. I'm not very smooth on my mouse, am I? Right, so it's necessary now to start to apply a little bit of the brake. Take it down. We're at the lights. We're under 120, half a kilometer. No, sorry, 800 meters to go. Decent. Not bad. Arrival time is looking relatively decent, not bad either. Half a kilometer and 90 kilometers, so we do need to step on some brake now. Get her coming down. Quite steady here. Everything's in the green. Customers are all happy. 60 as we're coming onto platform. It's not a big platform by the looks of things. That brings us onto platform, so we will just start to apply our brake here now. There we go. People are walking out before the doors open. Well now, we have arrived before the 11:04 arrival time. Our departure time is 11:04 as well, and our next arrival time is 23, so 19 minutes from leaving here. We finish this carry-on. Now if I get anything decent in terms of an arrival bonus, I think we might be in just a slight chance of cancelling our debt. Who knows? There we go, 167. Yeah, we are in a good chance of cancelling our debt. If only we can avoid silly mistakes. We might actually walk away with enough credits for half a cup of cold tea. 150, and we're out. We're leaving at 11:04:36. 35 is when I pushed out, or even maybe a little earlier actually. Well within the 4th minute past the 11th hour of the day. So, show. We have a 200 coming up. I think we're going to have to hold it off at the 150 mark, just for the time being. Yeah, 40 kilometers an hour of headroom left. Well, maybe not, actually. 30 left with a kilometer point 1.8. Yeah, we're going to have to hold off. So we're not out of the woods. We're looking good. We're looking pretty good, but we're not golden or anything near it. Yeah, I'll have to take the heat out of that current right now. You really want a nicer promo? Sounds stupid. Sounds Lower East Side stupid, that's what I'm talking about. 200 coming up. We are 8 under with 38.25 kilometers to go. And we get to do 200. Slap it up a gear. Let's rock and roll. Show me the money. And that sentence has no relevance at all. But anyway. Now it'd be nice to have a decent run. Our arrival time is 1:23. Yeah, 1:23 scheduled, 1:22:11 estimated at the moment, actual 11:06. I keep saying 1:22, I mean to say 11:22. What's wrong with me? $200 is predicted going forward as well, so should be not too bad. Speed. Ah, look at that, Mukos. Mukos. Yes. Yes, I'm going to rescue. I'm here. Okay, let's kind of keep it tidy. Some sheep over there, and then what have we got in here? Oh, I didn't see that. Things are moving by at 195 kilometers an hour. And I don't want to incur any more speed, so we're going to keep it inside the cab here, folks. We're going to keep it inside the cab. You guys can look out. Scenery is pretty decent. It's nice. I like that place in France. Yes, yes, yes. Q, Q, Q. While we're holding nicely here at the 200 predicted, let's move up a little bit. Just to maximize our run, let's get it up to 98 or 99. 394 amps for maintenance, but no, I'm accelerating slightly. Should be around the 24%, somewhere in that ballpark. I'm slowing down a little there. Still slowing down. .5 kilometers. And we look like we're making good time. Deutsche Bahn. 350 amps is holding our steady state, which is cool. We are making up a little bit of time. Sounds just as bad outside the cab as it does inside. No. Looks like we're going much slower here, doesn't it? That's how you speed up. That's how you slow down. Very slow there. That's just playing. 1:21:42 on estimated 11:21:42 estimated 11:23. So we're making pretty decent time at the moment. Just going to add a little bit more juice to those big electrics and get ourselves on station comfortably within the limit. Let's see if we can cancel out that 103 negative points. We won't do that if I accelerate much past 200 though, Jack. Queuing my way. 160 coming up. We have a 160 coming up. in a long distance. It seems a couple of kilometers away still, but it is on our radar. And there it is, 2.7 kilometers. We got a 160. We're 21 kilometers out, so this is a slowdown to 160, so that we can surely accelerate back to 200 a little bit later. So we're just taking out the juice, and yeah, I got it. I'll start applying brake now, just to keep it quiet. There you go, look, you see, we're coming down. We have a kilometer to go, train. Chillax, for God's sakes. There's my 160, I'll reach that now. Yes, for God's sakes, give it a rest. There's our 160 in due time, plenty of time, we're looking good. We're looking good. Now don't get too confident here, because you know how easy you can just make a boop out of this. Real easy. Good old section of 160 here, we're 18.3 kilometers out. We're good on time, we're good on speed. We got fuels in the tank and we got our customers in the green. And we have a horn that is not even as good sounding as what I had on my push bike when I was a 5-year-old. Again. Einhundert sechzig Kilometer pro Stunde. And there's a plural of sheep. It's sheep in the field. There's plural sheep in the field. 158. There's a nice road. Ain't it pretty? It's a pretty good view, actually. It looks like there's sheep out there. No, they're not. They're bales. Let's just take a smidgen off that so we don't overrun. 110. 110 is a long way away, though. But, yeah, okay. That's 15 kilometers. What the hell am I doing down to 110 for? It's 2.5 kilometers away, and I need to drop 40. Now 50 if I go up to 160. We can do that. Langenhagen Pferdmark. So this is the Langenhagen horse market. We're gonna go flying through it. I'd blow my horn to scare the horses just for fun, which wouldn't be a nice thing to do. Because they can stampede and kill people, but the horses would probably laugh. However horses laugh. Be like Mr. Ed on TV. Those of you who are of an age and perhaps of a nationality will get that, and those of you not of an age, irrespective of your nationality, won't probably get that. Just look up the horse Mr. Ed on Google. Google is your friend. Google is the answer to all the questions we have. No need for universities anymore. In fact, I jest, but I'm kind of... Let's put it this way, universities do have a slight competition. Google doesn't have the ability to issue a certified piece of paper to say that you're a qualified idiot. But having been through the university system myself, let's say I was left a little bit flat as a result of it. My expectations going in were quite different to the reality I learned once I was inside it for a while. I wouldn't have been a super classy student, but I wasn't ending up as a lemming either. University had a lot of good things to it as well. I would recommend it. I'm not against it, but I do believe that one can apply oneself using the resources that are more available and free, and with a bit of discerning and common sense, acquire maybe even a better standard of the information that universities charge a lot of money to disseminate. I do really get the feeling that university is just a very big business, product of which is kind of self-sustaining, really. There's our 110 marker coming up, and it's 1.8 kilometers away and getting smaller, so I think we'll just bring it down a little bit. We have not got that much time in hand, we have 52 seconds in hand. Yeah, what have we got to do? 25 to go, 20, 15, 10, 5, alright, should be enough to run out. Yes, sir, look at me, I'm speeding, I'm not speeding, I'm slowing down. I am doing quite well. I'm one over, I'm on the money, I'm under. Now. 40 coming up, and that's going to come up not that quickly, but it's coming up. Oh, I'm 5.5 kilometers away from Hanover. Hauptbahnhof, Gleis 4. 11.23. Yes. Ende has come up. That lit up. What's that doing? This is telling us that the end is coming up, I suppose. Which, yeah. Which is all very good. Now we have a 40 coming down, and I think now we are driving merely on visuals, because we've got no indicators at all outside. Apart from this thing, which says I can do 110, which, like, whatever, because all of these are zeroed out now, and our pointer has gone down to zero, so I think we are driving merely on whatever we're supposed to be doing in the standard arrival pattern. Unlike in England, I don't see any speed limits on the signs outside. Although there's a 60 coming up, but that's because it's on this damn HUD. I don't know where this 110 is from, and without the HUD I don't know how I would know that. Please help me if you can explain that, I'd appreciate understanding. Okay, so we're 2 kilometers, 2.5 kilometers out from the end of the platform. And our time looks like it's okay. 23 is the arrival schedule. And 23.10 is, well, it'll be within the 23rd minute is our estimated. Our actual is just stroking 20 minutes past the hour in 5 seconds from now. We need to be getting down to 60 within the next third of a mile, or third of a kilometer even. So we'll apply a little bit of brake. I don't even know if you're supposed to blow the horn at other trains. I don't know what I'm doing at all. As if you didn't know that already. 60 is our target speed limit here, and I know that only because it's written on this stupid HUD, although the stupid HUD is still telling me I can do 110. Is it those 6? Does that 6 on the ground mean 60? Well, if there's a 4 up ahead here, then, oh no, 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 no. That's just wrong. That's just wrong. That's just wrong. Ah, this is just... that. Really now, that's annoyed me now. Because the 40 is here, and this thing has already said 40, and now I'm screwed. Yeah, that's... seriously, am I missing some... I'm not missing something here, this is... let's not be stupid now, let's just knock it down and... get to a stage of limiting our damage, but that's... I want to use lots of bad words. I must resist using bad words, that's just really annoyed me now. Like... yeah. That's not very good. I don't think I like this anymore. This scenario is not very good. You know, this HUD is just like, it's telling me 60 now all of a sudden, like what the hell? You know? Maybe that's a legitimate number to come up, but the frickin' HUD was showing 40 at that time. And... Stop. Okay, well, there's no way we're going to end this session. That's just... yeah, I... Really, that's just kind of annoying. In a game that demands attention and demands concentration, and God knows I have my lapses in it, but to be penalized for something that I have no control over is a totally different prospect, and that's not at all cool. Nice walking style there, lady. So, nothing wrong with the train, nothing wrong with the game, but the way the scenario is built by whoever built it, I don't know. Yeah, thanks very much. Like, a lot of this is my fault for the speeding in the early part, but right towards the end, and I've lost out huge points here. 40s and 30s across the board, and this section here is, that's just downright wrong. Not pleased. Return to main menu. Very, very, very annoyed. But I'll get over it because it's only a game. And maybe what I'll start to do is I'll abandon this scenario and start looking at the Steam Workshop and pull down a few scenarios that have some good feedback and start playing those, because quite honestly, there's nothing much fun about working hard to control the controllables as best you can, only to be, you know, just torpedoed. Now, maybe I have this totally wrong and I screwed up. Please feel free to tell me where. I'd love to learn. I want to get better at this. I do enjoy the challenge. But is it just me, or does anybody else have these concerns? So that was it, folks. That's another session. Thanks for watching, and be safe. Catch you next time.